Hola, bienvenidos. Hello and welcome. My name is Vera and I'm here to show you some tips about the pronunciation of the letters and the words in Spanish. And why is pronunciation in Spanish the first lecture that I'm doing as introduction to Spanish? Well, it's easy to answer that. If you know how to pronounce letters and words in Spanish, you'll be able to read correctly in Spanish, and that's a really important thing when learning a language. Also, if you watch this course, you'll find a lot of new words. Why is this important? Well, you will expand your vocabulary, and that will help you to better express yourself in Spanish. If you like this lecture and you want to know more about the pronunciation in Spanish, check out the link in the description. The first thing we are going to cover are the letters of the Spanish alphabet. What you need to know about the Spanish alphabet is that there are 27 letters and 5 digraphs. We'll be covering here the letters. So let's see the pronunciation of each one of them. We have here A, then B, C, D, E, F, G. Next one. H, I, J, K, L, M, N. One characteristic letter of the Spanish alphabet. Ñ, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, or Y, and Z. So, the only difference with the English alphabet is in the letter Ñ, which is a characteristic letter for Spanish alphabet, and it's pronounced Ñ. One important thing that you need to know is that the letter H is written but is not pronounced. So, for example, we have the word hotel, which has the letter H written in it, but it's not pronounced in Spanish. So in Spanish, we pronounce it hotel. After going over the letters of the Spanish alphabet, let's see how we can pronounce the letter R. So we have here the difference in the pronunciation between the digraph double R and the letter R. The digraph is a group of two letters with only one sound. So, this digraph double R we pronounce R. The digraph double R always goes between vowels and is pronounced strongly. So, let's see the examples. Carro, perro, R, hierro. This is how we pronounce the digraph double R. But we also pronounce the letter R strongly, like the digraph double R, when we pronounce it like that, at the beginning of the word. So, if we have the letter R, just one R, at the beginning of the word, we pronounce it strongly, like we have a digraph. So, let's see the examples. Ropa, reír, río, Roma. So, let's see this example here, because we have two letters R, one at the beginning that is pronounced strongly and one at the end that is pronounced softly. So, we pronounce this word reír, and I pronounce the letter R like R when it goes after L, N or sub. Let's see the examples. Enrique, alrededor, subrayar. I pronounce it strongly, but it's not written with a digraph. It's written with just one letter R. And one is pronounced softly in all the other cases. Let's see examples. Caro, crece, señor. Mejorar, gracias, flor. Empezar, abrazo, pero. Ahora, salir, poder. Transporte, aprendo. So, I pronounce it softly in all these cases. And, like we have seen, the digraph R and in these two cases the letter R is pronounced strongly. Now that you know the difference in the pronunciation between the digraph double R and the letter R, you can do this exercise. So I will show you here this exercise where you have two underline letters with sound R and uncircle letters with sound R. The example is claro for the sound R and carro for the sound R. You have here the other examples, you just have to underline or uncircle the letters R. If you have any problems while doing this exercise, please don't hesitate to contact me. You have my email here, it's vera.belgrado@gmail.com. I also give private classes, so if you have any questions, please just write me an email and I will be glad to answer you. There's just one thing you should know. If you enter the link in the description and watch my online course, you will find a discount code for private classes. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it and find it useful. And adios. Bye.